Hello everyone, let's continue with the basic electronics video lecture sessions. Today we will study about the bridge rectifier and filter topic of chapter 1. Dear students, we all know what is the rectifier, that is the diode circuit which converts AC into pulsating DC. That means it is pulsating DC output, it will have not pure DC. It will give you the output which will be the pulsating DC, which will have AC component as well as DC component. So let's start with the rectifier circuits types. We will have the two main types of rectifier circuits, one half wave rectifier and another, that is the full wave rectifier. The half wave rectifier, which will require only one diode, that we have studied already in the previous lecture, the circuit diagram and operation. And in full wave rectifier, it requires 2 or 4 diode according to the next 2 types of the full wave rectifier. Full wave rectifier, actually it is again classified into the 2 types. One is center tap the full wave rectifier and another, that is the bridge rectifier. Now let's start the circuit diagram and operation of bridge rectifier. Look at this. This is the bridge rectifier circuit diagram. The components which are used for the bridge rectifier are step down transformer, diodes and load resistance. We require 4 diodes to design the bridge rectifier. The components of bridge rectifier are step down transformer, 4 diodes, PN junction diode and 1 load resistance. As shown in this figure, we will connect the step down transformer and we will apply the 230 volt AC input voltage to the primary winding of transformer. Then there is one bridge of 4 diodes and finally we will collect the output across load resistance RL. So let's study about the operation of bridge rectifier for AC input voltage. Look at this. This is the bridge rectifier for positive half cycle. I'll be discussing there are 2 main cases of bridge rectifier operation. Case 1 during positive half cycle and case 2 during negative half cycle. So what will happen during positive half cycle? If we will apply the AC input and if we will discuss about the working during positive half cycle, then see here A becomes plus and B becomes negative. That means A terminal of secondary coil of transformer, it will become positive and B will become negative. So according to this, the diode will be biased. That means forward biased or reverse biased. D1 and D2 will be forward biased and D3 and D4 will be reverse biased. So dear students, during positive half cycle, what happens? D1 and D2 behaves like a short circuit, closed switch, and D3, D4 will be open switch. So now the next task is to draw the current direction. How the current flows? The current will flow from A to B. That means plus terminal to minus terminal, positive to negative. So current starts to flow from A, then it goes towards the D1, then current flows through the RL, then current will flow through the D2 diode which is short circuited or on, and then current reaches at the end point, that is negative point, and it is B. Thus current direction is A to B. The current path is A, D1, RL, D2, B. So we will get the output voltage across RL and that is also positive half cycle because current flows from RL from top to bottom. The direction of current flow is clockwise and through RL, that is from top to bottom. Now let's discuss about the bridge rectifier for negative half cycle. This is the case 2 of operation. When negative half cycle arrives in the input, then A terminal becomes negative and B terminal become positive. Therefore, the diode biasing condition will be reversed. D1, D2 will be reverse biased and D3, D4 will be forward biased. So that D1, D2 will be open switch, current cannot flow through the D1, D2 and D3, D4 will be closed switch. So the direction of current flow will start from the B, means always current will flow from positive terminal. So the current path will be, it will start from B, then which diode is closed? D3. It is closed switch, therefore B, D3, RL, then again the current will flow through the D4 and then it will reach to the negative terminal A. Thus, you can define the current flowing path from B, D3, RL, D4, A. So, according to the closed switch D3 and D4, we will have the output. Thus, according to the current flowing direction from B to A, but you need to notice, I'll again repeat, that the current flows from B to A, but through RL, the current will flow from top to bottom, the same direction as in the previous case during positive half cycle. Thus, during positive half cycle and during negative half cycle, the current flows through RL load resistance from top to bottom in the same direction. That's why output across load resistance will be also in the same direction, positive. So we will have, this is the output voltage waveform. During negative also we will get the positive half cycle at the output. So according to the circuit diagram and working case 1 and case 2 during positive and during negative half cycle, we can draw the waveforms. So let's draw the waveform for positive half cycle. Here we have the input voltage waveform, that is sine wave. I have drawn here only the positive half cycle and output will be also positive half cycle, as D1 and D2 will be on within 0 to pi. Similarly, during negative half cycle, if you want to draw the waveform, then look at this. These are the waveform for negative half cycle. Again, I have drawn here the two axes. One is for input voltage and another is for output voltage. So this is the sine wave which will be applied to the input, 0 to pi, that is positive half cycle, and pi to 2 pi, that will be the negative half cycle. So we will consider here the negative half cycle from pi to 2 pi. During pi to 2 pi, RL current, means the current flows from RL always in the same direction as in the positive half cycle. So we will have the positive half cycle in the output voltage from the pi to 2 pi, same as well as positive half cycle. Finally, let's draw the combined waveform for any of the bridge rectifier, any of the cycle, positive or negative. So look at this, this is the waveform for combined operation of case 1 and case 2. The first input cycle, that is the AC sine wave, which is applied to the transformer input. Then during positive half cycle, D1 and D2 on, and we will get the two outputs. One is output current and another is the output voltage. Output current is nothing but the V by R. As per the Ohm's law, V equal to IR. So you can measure I equal to voltage upon resistance. So you can also draw the output current waveform like this. And from 0 to pi during positive half cycle, D1 and D2 on, and from pi to 2 pi, D3, D4 will be switched on. That's why when you want to draw the output waveform of voltage V out, then D1, D2 on, so we'll get the positive half cycle in the first positive half cycle of the input. But in second negative half cycle of the input, again we will get the same output according to the previous, means positive half cycle, because the current flows from RL in the same direction from top to bottom. But in this negative during half cycle, D1, D2 will be off, but which are the on diodes? Those are D3, D4. So diode D3, D4 will be on. Similarly, from 2π to 3π, this cycle repeats because we are applying AC sine wave at the input. Again D1, D2 on, and we will get the positive half cycle. Then again, in the negative half cycle, we will get the positive half cycle because D3, D4 on, and current flows through the RL in the same direction. So finally, these are the output waveform for bridge rectifier. Those are V in and V out, most important waveforms. So now, let's draw the circuit diagram of bridge rectifier with filter. Actually, when we are studying the bridge rectifier or any of the rectifier, the output will be pulsating DC according to the definition. But if you want the pure DC, you need to connect the filter, and we can connect the inductor filter or capacitor filter. Here I have connected the capacitor filter across RL to get pure DC, to remove the pulsations from the input. And what is the input of filter? That is the output of rectifier. Thus, output of rectifier, that is rectified output, which is pulsating DC, that is applied to the capacitor filter. Now, what is the function of capacitor? The capacitor charges or discharges according to the input. So look at, these are the waveform of bridge rectifier with capacitor filter. So according to this, if we will connect the bridge rectifier and capacitor filter at the output, then 0 to pi positive half cycle, and we are getting the positive, positive, positive output in any of the cycle of the input for bridge rectifier, and that is rectified output. But in rectified output or at the input peak, as peak arrives, the capacitor charges. And if capacitor charges, you will get the pure DC. Then during negative half cycle, the capacitor starts to discharge, but it cannot immediately discharge completely, and immediately before discharging, the next peak arrives, and so that capacitor charges again. Thus, using filter, we'll get the capacitor charging within very short time period, and will get the continuously pure DC or practically close to DC. So during positive half cycle, D1, D2 on, and during negative half cycle, D3, D4 on, and that's why any two diodes will remain on or switched on or closed switch, current can flow through the load resistance continuously from top to bottom. And that's why we are getting the output continuously positive, positive, positive across RL. And when we will connect the filter, we'll get the filtered output. So dear students, if you face any difficulty in bridge rectifier or filter, you can mail me or you can ask me anytime. So that's all about today's session. Thank you very much.